fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning.
And this Mass will continue to pray for all of us, all of you, our parishioners. We remember especially those who are sick, Sophia, the brethren, and all others we know who are sick. We commit them into God's hands, asking that in His mercy, that He will bring them healing and brighten our days through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we are sinners in need of God's grace. Let us take a moment, therefore, to recall the times we have sinned against God and man, to be sorry for those times, and humbly ask God for His pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, you raised us to new life. Lord, have
mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood.
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may the Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whose grace, though sinners, we are made just, and though pitiable, we are made blessed, stand, we pray, by your words, stand by your gift, that those justified by faith may not lack the courage of perseverance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A proclamation of the Acts of the Apostles. After much debate had taken place, Peter got up and said to the apostles and the presbyters, "My brothers, you are well aware that from early days God made His choice among you that through my mouth the Gentiles would hear the word of the gospel and believe. And God, who knows the heart, bore witness by granting them the Holy Spirit, just as He did us. He made no distinction between us and them, for by faith He purified their hearts. Why then are ye now putting God to the test by placing on the shoulders of the disciples a yoke that neither our ancestors nor we were able to bear? On the contrary, we believe that we are saved through the grace of the Lord Jesus, in the same way as they." The whole assembly fell silent, and they listened while Paul and Barnabas described the signs and wonders God had worked among the Gentiles through them. After they had fallen silent, James responded, "My brothers, listen to me. Simon has described how God first concerned Himself with acquiring from among the Gentiles a people for His name. The words of the prophet agree with this, as is written, 'After this I shall return and rebuild the fallen hut of David. From its ruins I shall rebuild it and raise it up again, so that the rest of humanity may seek out the Lord, even all the Gentiles on whom my name is invoked. Thus says the Lord, who accomplishes these things, known from of old. It is my judgment, therefore, that we ought to stop troubling the Gentiles who turn to God, but tell them by letter to avoid pollution from idols, unlawful marriage, the meat of strangled animals, and blood. For Moses, for generations now, has had those who proclaim him in every town, as he has been read in the synagogues every Sabbath." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, proclaim God's marvelous deed through all the nations.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds through all the nations.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all ye lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
God has marvelous deeds to all nations.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations. Among all peoples, his wondrous deeds.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all nations.
Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the people with equity.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
He said, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Hallelujah,
Hallelujah.
That the salvation that Christ brought was for them. And if anybody wants to take a share in that salvation, the person has to do something. And what is that? Become a Jew. It's like me saying, it's like you telling me, if you want to come to America, you need to bleach and be white. You get what I mean? But then, Christ has told us, no. The salvation I brought is for everybody. It cuts across people and nations and tongues and everything. It's not meant for a specific tribe or race or color. And that was why in Acts of the Apostles chapter number 10, Peter had a dream to go and convert Cornelius. And he thought, look, this is unjust. And God gave him the trance and lowered the tray. And he had a variety of things that for him and the Jews, those were unclean. God said, no, do not call anything I have created unclean. Do not classify anything. I do the categories, not you. Today, we saw the same thing in the Acts of the Apostles today. The Jews and the Gentiles. The Gentiles are becoming believers and believing in God, accepting the word, getting transformed, marching unto heaven. And the Jews thought, no, this is unbecoming. Salvation is ours. It is not for them. They must be circumcised if they want to go to heaven. If they want to become Christians, they have to do what we are doing. What you are doing is not the way to salvation. God has given us only two things for salvation. The love of God and the love of neighbor. And every other thing is just trash. Because they are what? Embedded in the two. So do not expand it. Sometimes in our lives it is like that. We want to encapsulate people and dictate for them what to do and what not to do. But the Lord is asking us today, my brothers and sisters, love one another, and that is it. And that was why the Barnabas stood up. James did the same thing and others. They all spoke at different times. Peter spoke, Paul spoke. But they said to themselves, my brothers, let us not burden others. Let us not make their lives more difficult because they have accepted the faith to be saved. Why don't we teach them what the Lord has said? Abstain from strangled animals. Be chaste. Honor God. Love your neighbor. Let us teach them what God has taught us, what Christ taught us, what we heard from Him. What do you bring to the table at every meeting, in your house, at every group, at every gathering? Are you among those who want to stifle the situations of others? When we discuss people, what do we discuss about them? How to bring them to Christ? How to better their lives? How to let their light shine? Or how to push them apart? Make them isolated? And make their lives more miserable? Today, the apostles said, no, we are not going to make their lives more miserable. We are going to make it better. Because they have chosen the better life. And they should enjoy that greatness of the better life. Why don't we do the same in our relationship with one another? In everything we do, why don't we strive not to burden people, but to unburden them? To make their lives worthwhile and meaningful. To give them a joyful moment each time they spend with us, that they may long to have time with us the more. We can all do it. Because the Lord has filled us with His Spirit. And He says that our joy may be complete. Our joy will never be complete if we do not see that Christ in another and bring Him into ourselves. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us rise and in faith and joy bring our needs and our joy to our loving Father.
That Pope Francis, the bishop, and the whole church be strengthened and guided by the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civil leaders be given the grace to understand that all human life from conception to natural death is a God-given right. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That daily we pray for vocations for priesthood and religious life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we always offer praise and thanks to God for all the gifts we receive. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the poor, the hungry, the oppressed, and the sick may know God's care for them because of our assistance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may enter into the divine presence of the Holy Trinity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, in your mercy, look upon our hearts. Grant us a generous heart to accept others, to free them, to share your joy with others. Help us to come out of our darkness and to rejoice in your wonderful light. God our Father, may your joy be complete in us as we give your words. Come to our aid and fill us with that joy that knows no bounds. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of our creation. Through your goodness, we have bespoke this bread to offer, which ever given the human hands have made. May become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. May it become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with a comfort and a contrite heart. May the Lord wash over our sins and cleanse us from all iniquities. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
Amen. O God, by whom the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, St. Paul, St. Anthony, St. Augustine, St. Philip, St. James, St. Timothy, St. Matthew, St. Lawrence, St. Timothy, St. Bartholomew, St. Elizabeth, St. Cecilia, St. Andy Bolton, St. Josephine Bakita, St. Agatha, St. Monica, St. Lucy, St. Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father,
In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us call God Father in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and joy of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all of us.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share a sign of peace with each other.
Of God.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
My brothers and sisters, behold Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Christ died for all, that those who live may live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and is risen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, love, and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have a great day.
You too, Father. Thank you.